We go now to our reporter, Laura Windsor, on assignment.
Pancreatic disease, also known as pancreatitis, is an inflammation of the pancreas. We asked Dr. Kambiz Kosari at Valley Presbyterian Hospital in the San Fernando Valley to explain the function of the pancreas and the symptoms of the disease.
Pancreas is an organ that lives in the back wall of the belly. And the first portion of the small bowel, it is called the duodenum, and that wraps itself around the head of the pancreas. And the pancreas has a set of channels that essentially collect all the pancreas juice. They bring them in and they enter into the bowel at a point where we call the ampulla of water. So that's that muscular door that allows pancreas juice to come out, doesn't let intestinal juice to come back in. Right around the same area is where the bile duct is, which is the tube that drains the liver. And that pierces through the head of the pancreas, comes in and joins the pancreatic duct. So both of these tubings, they drain their juices into the same spot, into the intestines. It has several functions. One of them is the what we call the endocrine function, which is producing hormones that allows the body to control several things inside. There is the main function of the pancreas, which is the exocrine function, or it's the amount of digestive juices that the pancreas makes that then come into the intestines and allow us to digest our food. So you need both functions to have a normal, healthy life. The most common cause of pancreas problems is essentially pancreatitis or swollen pancreas from things like gallstone disease or alcohol-related issues. People who are obese, they're at a higher risk for gallstone formation, especially if you're a woman of childbearing age, for instance. Alcohol actually affects the pancreas cells themselves, and it causes an internal injury to those cells. Those cells get swollen as well. They break down and they release these digestive enzymes that they were supposed to put into the pancreatic duct. So the whole gland gets swollen again. And it can behave similar to gallstone pancreatitis, where you can have a very swollen pancreas. It can progress to necrotic pancreatitis, which is dead pancreas, and then also progress to infected necrosis. The problem with both of these issues, any cause of pancreatitis, is that if the cause of the pancreatitis keeps coming back, the pancreatitis will come back. And then after enough of pancreatitis, you get into what's called chronic pancreatitis. But specifically for pancreatitis, if you live a healthy lifestyle, if you keep your cholesterol levels low, you have a lower chance of developing gallstone disease, gallstone pancreatitis. Certainly, if you're drinking in excess on a regular basis, you're putting yourself at a much higher chance of developing acute pancreatitis. And then that becomes an addiction, which then means that you're at a higher chance of developing chronic pancreatitis. Very important that people understand that you have to have some expertise in this area. Not all physicians are familiar with how to deal with this disease.